Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can display this pattern using C programming. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through this link, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can download my Android app, that is Techimiz, which is based on programming, available at Google Play. Now coming on to the topic. First, we have to understand how this pattern will be displayed on console, because first we have to print space and then digits. So I am writing it like this. You can see I am replacing space with hyphen. So this hyphen is for understanding purpose. It will not display on console. At console, output will be printed like this. Digits with spaces. So now if we identify spaces and number of digits, so you will count in first row 4 spaces and 1 digit is printing, in second row 3 spaces and 2 digits are printing, then in third row 2 spaces and 3 digits are printing, fourth row 1 space and 4 digits, then in fifth row 0 space and 5 digits. So this way, to print space, we require these number of repetitions, and for printing digits, we require these number of repetitions. So if we are printing first row, then a loop will be required which will print spaces 4 times, and another loop which will print digit 1 time. Then in second row, space loop will repeat 3 times and digits loop will repeat 2 times. And this way, all the loops will be printing spaces and digits. Now to control these two loops, one for space and one for digit, we require third loop, which will be controlling which number of row you are printing. So this way, total 3 loops are required to print this pattern. Now I am going to implement the code. Here, I am implementing first loop that will be responsible for identifying number of rows. So this loop will identify which row we are printing. Now for printing spaces, I am implementing second loop, which is J, and inside this loop I will print spaces. So now you have to identify that for first row, this space loop must be repeated 4 times. So now let's check it. Suppose value of n is 5, which is received through scanf as number of rows. So I loop will begin from 1. Condition is true. Control will be transferred to J loop. So J is starting from 1. Now check this condition. I have subtracted n minus I. So n is 5 always. And I is 1 this time. So 5 minus 1 is 4. So this loop will repeat 4 times. And that is the requirement of our logic. That in case of printing first row, space loop will be repeating 4 times. Now after this loop, I am implementing another loop, that is K, which is starting from 1. It is repeating I times. Inside this loop, I am printing K. And after termination of this loop, slash n will be displayed. So here, value of K will be displayed. So first time I is 1, so this loop will repeat 1 time. And that is the requirement of our logic. Digits loop will repeat 1 time only. After termination of this loop, new line will be displayed. Second time I will be increased, so this I will become 2. Then control will be transferred to this J loop, which is printing spaces. So this time n minus I, so n is 5, I is 2. So n minus I means 5 minus 2, so it will be 3. So this J loop will repeat 3 times now, and K loop will repeat 2 times because I is 2, and K will be displayed here. So first time K will print 1 and then it will print 2. So this way the above mentioned loop will be displayed, sorry, above mentioned pattern will be displayed on console. So this third loop is for printing digits. Now I am executing this code. I am entering 5 as number of rows. You can see the output and you can compare it with this pattern. Both are same. So this way I have printed the required pattern with the help of C program. Here three loops are required. First for printing row number or rows. Second for printing spaces in a particular row. And third for printing digits in a particular row. And that particular row is provided by the I loop. So I hope you have understood how you can print the pattern using C programming and nested loops. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow my YouTube channel through this link, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. Thank you for watching this video.